grateful, we are thankful. And Lord, we ask that you touch those who are here. Lord, we pray your blessing upon each one. Now, Lord, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O my God, my Lord, and my Redeemer. Take me out of self, hide me behind your marvelous cross, and we shall be so careful to give you all the praise and glory. In Jesus' name, church, say amen.
Amen.
Turn with me, if you will, to Romans. Romans, the 10th chapter. Romans, the 10th chapter. Verse 17. If you will stand with me, amen. I just gonna read one verse, that's all. You can get up, and you can get back down. Amen. Romans 10 and 17. So then, faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. You may be seated.
Amen.
And I want to ask a question this morning as a subject. How do you hear God? How do you hear God? If in fact our instructions for our relationship with God comes through his word, how do you hear from God? I know we all should pray, and I pray that you do pray, that you do communicate with God, that you do commune with God, but how do you really hear from God? The Bible says faith come by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. It would imply to me that one of the major ways and number one ways of hearing from God is through his word. Amen. Through God's word. Amen. And if we measure that based upon our relationship with God, how often then do you hear from God? Yeah. How often do you hear from God? How often do you read his word?
Well, come on, preacher.
Make amen. How often do you pick it up and read it? When I was a young boy, my mother would make me read the Bible even when I didn't understand it. She would say, boy, sit down. You ain't doing nothing else. Sit down and read the Bible to me. And I would sit down and I would begin to read. And one of the books she would always make me read, two books actually. One was the book of Psalms and the other the book of Proverbs. And she would always tell me, one day you will need this for yourself. Now, if you're like most of us, when you start reading and don't understand it, it seemingly is saying nothing to you. Because you sit and you read it and you say, what does it mean? Well, I thought about that here yesterday when my two grandchildren came down to visit me, and I had to go to the bank on yesterday, and they said, Papa, can I cannot go with you? And I said, you can go with me if you understand what business is, because I have to go take care of some business. I said, do you know what business mean? And they said, no. I said, well, then you can't go with me. That was a sly way, wasn't it? Y'all know what I was doing. I said, you have to understand business. Love my grandkids. Don't misunderstand me. But then I thought about it. Isn't that how we are with God? And God is trying to do something with us. And he's trying to take us somewhere. And he asks us the question, do you hear me? And when you hear me, do you understand what it is I'm trying to tell you? He says, I heard you last night. I heard you crying last night. I heard what you were crying about. I looked into your heart, yes, and Lord, into your mind. Thank and you. I saw your pain. I read everything that was going on through every thought you had. And I have an answer. And I want to tell you where to find the answer. But it's been a long time since you've been to the instruction manual.
Well, tell the truth.
See, because in the instruction manual, it says, trouble may endure for a night.
But joy.
But joy.
Yes, it will.
Comes in the morning.
Yes, it will.
So I got the answer for all that you're going through if you just open up the Word of God. I know it sounds too simple, but that is how it's done. I've told you, if you don't know the story, I'll real quickly go through it, is that when I buy instruments, little gadgets, I have a hard time taking the time to read the instructions. I turn it on and I just wanted to do everything I wanted to do, never reading the instruction, never realizing that it would do more than I ever thought it would do if I just read the instructions. The camera that I own today, matter of fact, I gotta go get it fixed. After 5 years, it finally broke. I still don't know everything that camera can do, what it was designed to do. Why? Because I refused to read the instructions. And then what made it so bad was, is that one set of instructions came in Spanish and the other one came in English. I might as well have been reading the Spanish because I don't know what the English is saying anyway. But if I took my time to really want to know what that camera would do, I would read the instructions from cover to cover. But not just read it, but I would pick up the camera and I would hold the instructions in one hand, the camera in the next, and go through the very steps that it is telling me to go through so that I would learn how to use it to its full ability. God's word is just like that. Unless you pick it up and read it step by step, it all sounds foreign. And God is saying, I want to talk to you, but you are not hearing me.
God.
It's through his word. You say, Pastor, why through his word? John 1 and 1 says, in the beginning was the word, and the word was God, and the word was with God. And the Bible said, and the word became flesh and dwelt among us. God, Jesus is the word. And that if the word of God is in you, then you should know how it works.
Right.
God didn't leave you totally empty. He put himself in you. He allowed his spirit to dwell in you. And all you have to do is learn how to turn on the switch and make it all work for you. Oh, do we have bad nights? Yes, we have bad nights. We all have midnights. We all, but it's something about knowing what to do at midnight after everybody else done went to sleep, knowing how to call on the Lord, knowing how to find the comfort and the peace that God has for us. John 15. The Gospel of John, the 15th chapter, when Jesus is going through telling them, his disciples, that he is the true vine.
Mm-hmm.
Verse 7 says, if ye abide in me,
yes,
and my words
abide in
you.
Yes.
What is that?
You
should
ask.
You shall ask what you will, and it shall be done
unto you.
In other words, if you know how to use the book. If you know, because that's what it is to a lot of us, it's just a book. But the book has all the answers for all that we need in our life to get us through every day of our lives. Go to the Psalms 119. I'm going to spend just a minute. There's a Psalms 119 is one of the longest Psalms in the Bible. But it's so full of meat of what we need to understand about the importance of God's word and his statute and his precepts, and how the writer is telling us that he walks in his precepts. He lives within God's statutes. He